I forget every time how much I enjoy doing this. I really do. Whew. Good morning.
Flippin' physics.
Motional EMF is the idea that the motion of a conductor moving in a magnetic field can cause charges to move in the conductor, creating a voltage across the conductor. In other words, a conductor moving in a magnetic field can acquire an induced EMF across it. As an example, let's say we have a conductor in the shape of a long, thin rectangle moving to the right with a constant velocity at a right angle to the magnetic field, which is into the screen.
Sure. Objects can just fly at constant velocities through magnetic fields. That makes sense.
It's an airplane. He's showing a simplified version of an airplane wing flying through the Earth's magnetic field.
Right. Sorry.
Yeah. Yep. According to the right-hand rule...
Don't be too cool!
Limber up!
And find your right hand.
According to the right-hand rule, fingers point to the right with the velocity of the charges. Curl fingers into the screen with the magnetic field. Thumb points upward toward the top of the screen. That means positive charges will experience an upward magnetic force, and negative charges will experience a downward magnetic force. This will cause the charges to move, with the final result being that there will be a net positive charge on the top end of the conductor and a net negative charge on the bottom end of the conductor. This arrangement of charges creates a uniform downward electric field in the moving conductor.
I thought only electrons or negative charge carriers moved in conductors, right? That's what makes them conductors. They have lots of free electrons which are able to easily move around in the conductor.
That's why he used the phrase net charge when referring to the net charge on each end of the conductor. The positive end must have lost electrons to create a net positive charge there, and the negative end must have gained electrons to create a net negative charge there. He just likes to talk about what happens to both positive and negative charges in conductors to be complete or something. Right, Mr. P?
Sure, Bo. Yeah. As a result of the downward electric field in the conductor, positive charges will experience a downward electrostatic force, and negative charges will experience an upward electrostatic force. Because the conductor is moving at a constant velocity, the charges will arrange themselves such that equilibrium is reached between the magnetic and electrostatic forces acting on the charges, such that the electric field has a constant magnitude, and the charges in the conductor are moving with a constant velocity to the right. When it reaches equilibrium, there is no vertical motion of the electric charges. Billy, please sum the forces in the y direction on a positive charge in the conductor which is moving to the right at a constant velocity.
Absolutely. Well, the net force in the y direction acting on a positive charge in the conductor which is moving to the right at a constant velocity equals the magnetic force minus the electric force, which equals mass times acceleration in the y direction. Because the positive charge is moving to the right at a constant velocity, the acceleration of the charge in the y direction equals zero. That means the magnitudes of the magnetic force and the electric force are equal. The equation for the magnetic force is charge times velocity times magnetic field times the sine of the angle between the directions of the velocity of the charge and the magnetic field. Velocity is to the right and the magnetic field is into the screen. The angle between those two directions is 90 degrees and the sine of 90 degrees equals 1. That's the left-hand side of the equation. On the right-hand side of the equation, electric force equals charge times electric field, so
everybody brought charge to the party.
Everybody brought mass.
Please realize that if you summed the forces on a negative charge moving in the conductor instead, you will arrive at the same equation we have here. And Bobby, what is the equation for the voltage across a uniform electric field?
The equation for the voltage across a uniform electric field?
Remember, we derived the equation for the electric potential difference between two parallel plates. And two parallel plates of opposite charge create a uniform electric field, which is basically what we have here.
Kind of. It's been a while.
The voltage across a uniform electric field equals the negative of the electric field times d, the distance between the two plates.
Sure,
That looks familiar.
Thank you, Billy. We have already determined everything about directions here, so let's use the absolute value of the voltage. And let's identify the length of the conductor to be capital L, which is also the distance D, the length of the electric field in the conductor. We now know the electric field equals the voltage across the electric field across the conductor divided by the length of the conductor. And that also equals the velocity of the conductor times the magnetic field the conductor is moving in. We can rearrange that to solve to get that the induced voltage across the length of the conductor equals the velocity of the conductor times the magnetic field times the length of the conductor. In other words, the motional EMF built up between the ends of a conductor moving through a constant magnetic field equals the velocity of the conductor times the magnitude of the magnetic field times the length of the conductor. Again, this is called motional EMF.
But that equation assumes the angle between velocity and magnetic field is 90 degrees, right?
Valid point, Bo. This equation does assume the conductor is moving normal to the plane of the uniform magnetic field. If it is not, you would leave the sign of the angle in the equation. But yes, that is an important thing to realize. Thanks.
You're welcome.
Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoy learning with you.